here in front of the Black Academy of Arts and Letters Incorporated, a nonprofit performing literary and visual arts organization here in Dallas, Texas. This academy is the only African-American cultural arts organization in the country to be located in a major convention center. It was founded by Curtis King, producer and director of more than 150 productions. I'm going to have the opportunity to speak with him later this evening, as well as Narak Udab, Erica Badu's younger sister, who will have her debut performance here tonight. But before we do that, follow me inside and let's take a look at some of the beautiful artwork that you'll find throughout this amazing academy. The Black Academy of Arts and Letters Incorporated is a multidisciplined cultural arts organization located in the Dallas Convention Center Theater Complex. It was founded in 1977 by Curtis King, a respected theater producer and director. The Black Academy of Arts and Letters Incorporated houses the Clarence Muse Cafe Theater, the Naomi Bruton Theater, which seats 1,750 patrons, and also the James E. Kemp Art Gallery. This is where many notables have performed, such as Bill Cosby, Melba Moore, Olita Adams, Billy Preston, Erica Badu, as well as a host of many plays and performances. I'm here in Dallas, Texas at the Black Academy of Arts and Letters, and I'm standing here with Mr. Curtis King, founder.
Hey,
how are you?
Excellent. It's Friday night. We're having a good time.
Tell our viewers about the Black Academy of Arts and Letters.
Well, the Black Academy is a predominantly African-American arts institution that's housed in the Dallas Convention Center Theater Complex, which is in the heart of downtown Dallas, Texas. And it's a 250,000 square foot facility. We have two venues. We have an 1,800-seat theater, then we have a 216-seat cafe theater, which is right behind us, mm-hmm. have a wonderful gallery, a gift shop, administrative offices, and so on and so on and so on.
It wasn't always like this, though,
no,
right?
No, absolutely not. I started the project, actually, mm-hmm. with $250 on my dining room table,
wow.
25 years ago, and this year we're celebrating our 25th anniversary.
Congratulations.
Yay, I'm excited.
Wow, it's a beautiful, beautiful facility. Actually, it reminds me, some of you who may not have been to this facility, it does reflect a lot of resemblance to the Buffalo Langston Hughes Center, which kind of has the same type of flavor as
mm-hmm.
this facility.
But not like this.
We're getting there.
Okay.
But can you tell us what's going on this evening?
Well, tonight we have a wonderful performance by a young artist, brilliant artist, mm-hmm. Narak Udab. She's a sister of Erica Badu. And the interesting thing about Narak and Erica, they both grew up in this theater. Their mother used to bring them to the theater, and their godmother brought them
wow.
to this theater. Not this particular building,
right.
but to this theater. So now her godmother is working full-time with us, and her mother is a full-time volunteer.
Yes.
So, I mean, it's absolutely wonderful to have young artists who come back to the community or come back to your city
mm-hmm.
and work in an institution,
mm-hmm.
and to even live in a time where artists have an opportunity to be able to work in spaces where they pretty much grew up from. So we're excited about that.
Now, Erica Badu and her sister Narak,
right.
They both are born and raised here?
They're born right here in Dallas, Texas.
Okay, and yeah. her sister is?
Right here in Dallas, Texas. She's a wonderful artist. You know, you never really know how people are gonna turn out, but just
right.
certain things you can just kind of pick out in that personality and say, uh-huh.
She's gonna make it.
Yeah, she's
gonna
make it.
Something.
There's something
yeah.
in there. So you're excited about
oh, yeah,
a
I'm
lot
excited.
Of that.
Oh, yeah,
I'm
excited. I never knew anything about Narak.
I mean, like me and Cole,
I
never thought from Coldwater, Mississippi, which is where I'm originally from.
Right.
Little bit little town, about 25 miles south of Memphis.
Okay.
Never thought in my wildest imagination that I would have turned out to be like a producer, a director, things
wow.
like that. But I'm excited. I've worked with a lot of people. You know, Esther Rowe was my mentor.
Okay.
Vera Richards was my mentor. Margaret Walker, who was a great writer, she was my mentor. Maya Angelou was mm-hmm. my mentor. I mean, so I've had a lot of people to work as mentors to me, and that's why I'm always excited to be able to pass things on to other artists.
Now, if some of our viewers do come out this way, what are some things they can look forward to participating with your center here?
Well, one is that we have Melba Moore that's coming here,
okay.
Called Melba's Cabaret, because we have a dinner theater program. And then we have a piece called Wild Women Blues.
Okay.
Linda Hopkins, who is a Tony Award winner,
mm-hmm.
she's coming here. It's a wonderful show. It's never been done in the United States. It's been done in Europe for 3 years.
Okay.
So it's gonna have a world premiere here in the United States. Well, not a world premiere, it's gonna have U.S. Premier right. in the United States mm-hmm. at the Black Academy of Arts and Letters. And then we have a senator from Mississippi is doing a piece called The Eyes of Black Folks. It's a wonderful piece. I mean, there are a lot of things that we have going on. We generally attract about 550,000 people on an annual basis with the Black Academy.
Wow.
And we do about 135 or 40 programs a year. So it keeps us...
Yeah. How can we find out more about, is there a website, is there a number, is there
yeah, we have a website, and I cannot remember the website.
we'll get that later, that's
www.tbaal.org.
Okay.
Is that good?
Okay, that's good. We'll make sure.
Or they can call it 214-743-2440, 743-2440, area code 214. I mean, they can always call you.
And that's directly to the Black Academy of Arts and Letters.
And the interesting thing is that we always, always have a lot of people from around the country that are coming to things that we're doing.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we did a piece with Barbara McNair and Linda Hopkins last season, and we had a big group from Chicago that came here.
Mm-hmm.
Bill Cosby was here last season. Mm-hmm. A lot of things are going on.
Definitely. This is exciting. We're excited.
Cicely Tyson was here in November. Mm-hmm. Roger Moses was here. Antonio Fargas. Juanita Moore that played in Imitation of Life. She was here. Because we had a film feast, we call it.
Okay.
So it's good. I mean, it keeps you working, but it's very exciting. Because the other thing is, there aren't a lot of African American cultural institutions that are left in the country.
Right.
I mean, they're just dying on the grapevine.
And it's hard to keep them alive and to keep them surviving in the communities today. It's wonderful to see you doing so much and keeping the community active and keeping our culture alive.
Oh, yeah.
Beautiful. We thank you so much for your